Thank you. about the whole process.
I already got one, ma'am.
Muslim immigrants with the ban. and then they continue to attack black and brown communities with increased policing. There's also been attacks on trans people and now an attack on Dreamers and DACA. The wars in our homelands are becoming more intensified, and the Trump administration has been talking about nuclear war with North Korea. So we recognize that these actions today are ongoing attacks on all of our communities, on each and every one of us. And we know that DACA was never enough, but it gave at least some family stability, and it gave us some dignity to be able to continue living our lives the way we should be. But to remove DACA doesn't only impact those who are under it, it impacts all immigrant communities. The same type of immigration policies mirror the same things that we see under occupation in our homeland. Why do we hate people like Arapaio or Trump? Because they represent things like checkpoints, movement control, all of the oppressive things that they've continued to try to put on our communities. So you cannot delink what's happening abroad to what's also happening here. The same border wall built through Zionist agendas, also building walls here and creating the same policies against our people. And to all of the Muslims, working class, and those under DACA, it also means thinking about whether names and information could be turned over to Muslim registries, programs, or ISIS deportation programs. We need to talk about how to continue to support families instead of becoming pawns in the name of national security. And this is not, and I repeat, this is not a country of immigrants. It has a long history of systemic repression and oppression against people, built on the genocide of indigenous peoples and built off the backs of slaves. But at the same time, we've had a history of resistance, and we are continuing that history of resistance here today in San Francisco. We will continue to resist state terror. And although some of us as Muslims and Arabs are dreamers, today in this fight, we are all dreamers. We are on a quest for dignified, self-determined communities. Our resistance and our liberation is tied. An attack on one of us is an attack on all of us. Stay with me. An attack on one of us is an attack on all of us. So we will continue to push back on the fascists, like we did recently here in San Francisco, like we did in Berkeley. We will say no to fascism, no to imperialism, and no to white supremacy. Long live international solidarity, y'all. Thank you.
Thank you, Sharif. That was amazing. We will continue to stand. No ban, no wall. Century for all. No ban.
No wall. Century for all.
No ban.
For justice for everyone, for all of us to just live in
of our courage and of our race, because we are a race. Everything that we're seeing in our communities is not fair. The more than 2 million people who have already been deported and separated from their families are still with us. And as immigrants, we've known